I've been feeling fatigue and a lack of enthusiasm. What does it mean? Okay, that's a great one. So if you've been feeling fatigue and a lack of enthusiasm in your physical body, in your physical experience, it means a disconnect is happening. It means you're not listening to the voice of your own best interest. It means that you are believing you're a body that's disconnected. You are not a body, you are free. You are still as God created you. So if you're out of enthusiasm for life, that entheos in God is enthusiasm. It means you're disconnected. You're not connecting to what is in your best interest. And that's exhausting. That's an exhausting endeavor. When that happens, going back to those 9 principles that we said that will align you with your bliss body, one of them being quality sleep. If you find yourself exhausted and yet you keep on pushing on, quite possibly the thing that you're pushing on into is something that isn't aligned with your divine self, and you're not leaving the space or the stillness still as the divine created you, as God created you. You're not affording yourself that space for the circumstances you really want to arrive. So you're pushing and forcing yourself in a way that, of course, you're not enthusiastic. You're disconnected first. When that happens, allow yourself just to be kind to yourself for a moment. If you're confused and if you're feeling as though you're pressuring and pushing and prodding yourself towards a future that maybe isn't something you know for a fact is in alignment with delight, then you just want to take this break, this exhale. Do all of those things. Let yourself have rest. Let yourself shake it off. Move in a way that feels spontaneous and free. Let yourself think in quiet ways that are more in alignment with delight. Meditate. Do the things that are quality experiences from your body, from the outside in, that align you at a soul deep level. And you'll start to see that you're feeling more enthusiastic with the less you do, not the more you do. The more quality endeavors that you align with, the less you'll be doing. And the more you'll find yourself making greater impact by doing less. The soul is like a massive fulcrum. The bliss body is like a massive fulcrum. That little tiny leverage on there is going to make massive movements in your life. Whereas the disconnected self can make a whole lot of nothing happen all the time and feel like it's getting nowhere and work so hard at getting very little result. If you find yourself getting very little results, remember, stop attaching to results, because that would be an outside-in orientation. That's the ego's way of approaching things. Instead, let yourself relax. Take that time. I am not a body. I am free, for I am still as God created me. Get still for a moment. Connect with your bliss body, the one that's radiating from the inside out to heal every system and cell and organ of your body, to heal your mind, to allow yourself to feel this free, unencumbered, unconditioned experience that is your present life moving forward. And then focus on whatever brings you the most joy. If it's perfect health, just stay focused there. And again, no naysayers in the picture. Just say, thank you very much for your opinion. I'm moving into where I'm going. And know that nothing that's conditioned now, that is from the past and now is something that you're living in the present, is limited to what is. We can always shift and change and move beyond whatever it is that we're not satisfied with, that doesn't feel completely aligned with peace, joy, and love, by focusing on peace, joy, and love, the essence, the true essence of who and what we truly all are already. So there's our bliss body in a nutshell.